Now here on the bench I have both a spring and diaphragm rotary actuator and a piston rotary actuator. Let's first look at the operation of the spring and diaphragm actuator. The pressure loading connection is always located on the upper diaphragm casing. As pneumatic pressure is increased, it's applied to a diaphragm which transfers the force to a diaphragm plate. The diaphragm plate is connected to the actuator stem. The actuator stem connects to a lever that turns the valve drive shaft. Different lever styles may be used depending on the actuator design. A spring under the diaphragm plate exerts a force opposite the pneumatic pressure and moves the assembly toward the upper diaphragm casing when pressure is reduced. Piston actuators are typically double acting and operate by applying pneumatic pressure to both sides of a piston. The piston moves inside the cylinder and an actuator stem connected to the piston operates a lever to create rotary motion. Generally, a positioner is needed to operate a piston assembly for throttling control. Now that we know the basic operation of rotary actuators, let's look at valve and actuator orientation. The control valve action can be defined as push down to open, or PDTO, or push down to close, PDTC. This refers to the valve response to changes in the pneumatic signal to the actuator. In this example, a control valve with a spring and diaphragm actuator is configured for push down to open. As increasing pneumatic pressure moves the diaphragm, diaphragm plate, and actuator stem down to rotate the lever, the drive shaft rotates the valve into the open position. If there is a loss of supply pressure, the spring in the actuator will return the valve to the closed position. If the assembly had been configured for a push down to close orientation, the assembly would have failed open. The valve action and fail mode can be changed by switching the orientation of the actuator. Piston actuators may or may not include the use of a bias spring in the cylinder. Control valve action is still determined as push down to close or push down to open. However, if a bias spring is not installed in the assembly, there will be no inherent fail mode. We might need to use other devices to achieve the proper fail mode. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the classroom.